We've put the transducer down here to produce some traveling waves that are going to move vertically upward. And what we want to do is see how they interact with a plate that we're going to move into the path of these traveling waves. So I'll turn on the transducer after I put on my hearing protection. And there you see them. They're moving upward. And I'll slowly bring in this reflecting glass plate. Now, what's really cool here is you can see the waves actually sneaking around the plate into the shadow of it. So this is called diffraction. At the same time, you see waves being reflected down, and it's the superposition of the traveling waves moving up and the reflected waves moving down that gives us what we call a standing wave. I'll move the plate in a little further to see more of that standing wave. Now, there's something strange about the standing wave. It seems to be flashing on and off. And the reason that's happening is because the changes in the density in the standing wave are happening twice as fast as the frequency of the traveling waves. So to see the full standing wave, which we're not seeing right now, what we need to do is strobe at double the frequency of the traveling waves. So we're going to do that next. We are now strobing the light at twice the frequency of the traveling waves, and let's see what the standing wave looks like. You can see that the wave is not moving. It is definitely a standing wave. And if you recall, I marked the wavelength of the traveling waves every 1.2 centimeters. So if I put the scale into the path, you can see how the bands of light line up with the marks on the ruler. The marks on the ruler are every wavelength, and we actually have one light band between the marks, because the light bands appear every half wavelength. The distance between the transducer and the reflector is an integer multiple of half wavelengths.